2NURFM, a broadcast service of the University of Newcastle.
Once a fortnight, we chat with a very stylishly dressed gentleman, and you can't see it on the radio, but he always is. It's John Fischetti, our Professor of Education. And g'day, John. New school year, and of course, some of the same old problems. If you're heading out west, it can be tricky to fill some of those spots in the schools out there. A not so new idea of how that might be achieved.
Yeah, good morning, Mark. Happy Valentine's Day to you.
We'll move on.
So the government today is just releasing a report which is about whether the gaps are closing, particularly to benefit Aboriginal people of Australia. And in doing so, there's still a shortage of teachers in the rural and remote areas, in particularly in those that have a high population of Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander people. And this is a chronic problem, as you mentioned, and the issue is, well, how do we make that happen? And for most teachers coming out of university, or most current teachers, the incentives to go west or to go to where it's been, we'll call them hard to staff places, don't really make up for the disincentives of changing lifestyle, not being close to the beach, or family being so far away. Or where's the shopping mall, to be honest with you. So this is a possibility they might waive the HECS debt for their degree loans. And that's not a bad idea, actually.
It would be a huge game changer because, like you said, I mean, there is a trade-off, and let's be real. I mean, for most people, if you could stay near the coast or where everything else is, that would be your pick. But in all of the other schools and other areas, you need teachers, you need quality ones as well. So there has to be a way to sort of trade off, because everywhere is not equal.
And what we now know is the single most important variable that we can control in a student's life is actually the quality of that teacher, as you just mentioned. So if we can encourage more teachers to go to hard to staff areas. So here's two or three ideas that seem to make sense. One is wiping off the debt. The other is that's a 3 to 5 year contract. Because what we don't want to do to young people is have these sort of indentured servants come in for each year and leave them. What students need in their lives is continuity, someone they can trust, someone they have confidence in, who becomes part of the community, as opposed to is a one-off. That actually won't work.
And plus as well, I mean, if you're only there for a year, you've already got your eye on the next place.
Exactly.
But if you're there for 3 or 5 years because that's the agreement, there is always a chance that, you know what, I actually kind of like it here. I might stay for 10 years, or I might just plant a flag and stay till retirement.
The other thing that's worked elsewhere in the world, in rural and urban areas that are hard to staff, is accommodation that isn't the leftover rundown accommodation. So if the schools and the department in those regions built some apartments that were fit for purpose, people will actually say, I have an incentive financially, I'll have my debt waived, and I will have a place to live, maybe at a discount rate. It's going to take that kind of investment. But the real issue is, can we grow our own as well? Because young people tend to come back and teach closer to where they grew up, and that includes in the rural and remote areas. So really boosting the educational quality of their experience in school may make it more likely they go to university and more likely to come home to teach as well. So while we're bringing in imports, we also have to grow the local capacity to serve the region itself.
So these ideas are things that do come up quite a bit. Is there a lot of appetite for at least some of these measures to become a reality?
I think because these Closing the Gap reports have now gone on for a decade or so, and they're actually showing pretty mediocre results, it's going to take some dramatic solutions like this. They can continue to pay lip service to the fact the gaps exist, or we can do things like provide the incentives of waiving the loans. In the U.S., a program I was part of, we paid an extra $10,000 to math and science teachers to go to the western part of the state so that they would be in a 3 to 5 year commitment and waive their loans. Those things actually got people to go, and the quality then of the teaching improved, which then starts that cycle of getting kids building the capacity so they might actually be the next generation
and
be the teachers.
And some of those loans are quite pricey as well. I mean, we're talking, what, massive dollars in the US?
You know, when it's $50,000 a year to go to some private universities, you can come out with $200,000 debt to be a nurse or a teacher. The other component is our young people. Many of them are considering teaching all the way through secondary school. The top students, whether you want to use the ATAR or HSC results as a guide or other measures, but they tend to drop that down a bit as they get closer to finishing. If there are scholarships and incentives for them to go into teaching, and then also for them to start their career in the West, that will also work, because we can't make the assumption that they're not interested. It's just as they go forward to their education, sometimes they're told by the adults around them, oh, honey, you're probably not cut out to be that. If we actually make it prestigious, we give them scholarships, we'll recruit some students to go that direction, so we can grow it from the younger students, the mature age students, and then, of course, from the community itself. All those probably have to happen, because you're right. In the long run, most people will tend to say, what I'd rather do is be closer to the beach.
That's true. Hopefully we can have some mature conversations and get some of these things up and running, because otherwise schools are going to be not as they should be out west in rural areas of Australia. But we'll finish where we started. Valentine's Day, do anything nice this afternoon?
I've got to work probably late into the evening, but we'll do it on the weekend.
There won't be as many people out in the restaurants then. Smart thinking. Our Professor of Education, as always, some insightful information. John Fischetti on 2NURFM 103.7.